Constitutional Conversations is a series of discussions by America's leading scholars about the principles, framing, ratification, and implementation of constitutional government in the United States. This series is hosted by the James Madison Memorial Fellowship Foundation of Alexandria, Virginia.
Women in the post-revolutionary era continued to be engaged in politics. They read newspapers, they read political pamphlets. They became, in the language of the time, what were called female politicians. Now, it doesn't mean they held public office, but at the time, if you were a politician, it meant you were someone who was really interested and liked to argue about politics. And so there were a lot of female politicians as a result of the American Revolution. Women who thought that because they had participated in the revolution, they had a right to read about politics, to talk about politics. And so at the time that the Constitution was written, women continued to read and to think and to talk with their family and friends about their political views on ratification, whether the Constitution should be approved or not. There was one woman in particular, though, who played a public role in the debate over the ratification of the Constitution, and her name was Mercy Otis Warren. She lived in Massachusetts, and she was highly educated, more educated than most women at the time. And even before the American Revolution, she had written political tracts and plays and poems directed to the public, encouraging them to defend their rights and to fight for their liberties. She wrote under a pseudonym, which was typical at that time for both men and for women, the few women who wrote. When it came time to ratify the Constitution, she was really alarmed by some of its provisions. She believed that the Constitution extended the Republic over too vast a territory, that this new government couldn't possibly represent the interests of so vast and diverse a nation and a diverse a people. And most importantly, she was terrified because this new government had a lot of new powers, a lot of new authority over the people of the United States, but there was no Bill of Rights. Many of the states had bills of rights, but the U.S. Constitution, as it was originally written in 1787, did not have a Bill of Rights. And she really was disturbed about this. So she wrote a pamphlet and she signed it under the pseudonym A Columbian Patriot, and it was published in Massachusetts, and it was widely circulated in Massachusetts and in other states as part of the opposition, as the anti-federalist view opposing the ratification of the Constitution. So she was the most visible woman who participated in the debate over the Constitution. But you can bet that many other women had views about it, both pro and con.
Constitutional Conversations is made possible by a generous grant from the Fairleigh S. Dickinson Jr. Foundation. Constitutional Conversations is made possible by the James Madison Education Fund.